check, yeah, fest, check, yeah. Now which one of y'all was talking shit about the set? I come through in the drop Porsche, two-tone colors. Uh-huh. You and your man, y'all could be Tombstone Brothers.
What's good, y'all? It's the one and only Omar Fina, the most renowned voice in sports. Make sure that like button if you're new. Go and subscribe to the Phenomenal Crew while you're at it. Now, let's get to it. Well, listen. Listen, I got to change your heart, y'all. I do. I got to change your heart. And I got to come on here and let it be known. Russell Wilson, you're disappointing me right now. You really are. I know I aired up my piece at first when it came to the situation, and I sort of backed up Russell Wilson. The only critique I had about Russell Wilson the first time I reacted to the Dan Patrick show is, at the end of the day, when it comes to offensive line, you're getting paid $35 million, you're the third highest paid quarterback in the league, you gotta make it work. But what I get frustrated with Russell Wilson is it's not really the Dan Patrick show himself, him airing out the offensive line. Russell Wilson, if he really wanted to air out the offensive line, he could have done it a lot worse. At the end of the day, it's not like Russell Wilson called out Ethan Pochich for being a bum. It's not like he called out Jordan Simmons or Ipadi for being washed up. He didn't do that. At the end of the day, he just said he wants to be protected more and he doesn't want to take as many sacks going into his later years. But you got to remember, Russell Wilson is going to his 10th year. Russell Wilson is the middle of his prime. So, you know, watching Brady do what he's done and lead the Buccaneers to a Super Bowl and seeing Breeze and all these older quarterbacks play the how they are, at the end of the day, Russell Wilson just wants to make it there. And right now, everything has been great. Russell Wilson, listen. Russell Wilson has played in the league for the past 9 years. He got drafted in 2012. Been the starting quarterback ever since he's entered the league. Hasn't missed a single snap. Has played all 16 games in the first 9 years. Who can say that? Taking all the hits he's done. Russell Wilson is the most durable, the most toughest quarterback I ever seen in my life. So it's like at the end of the day, I get it from that perspective. But what I don't get is this. With all the trade rumors of all these teams looking for Russell Wilson, making offers for Russell Wilson, what I'm disappointed from Russell Wilson's perspective is this. You can easily deny these rumors. All it takes is three words. I'ma see y'all. Or better yet, I want the offensive line. I want to see the offense develop. But then I'ma see y'all forever. Listen, we all got Twitter. We all got Instagram. Matter of fact, since it's been about Twitter and Instagram, y'all make sure y'all follow me on those platforms. I keep my username in the thumbnail for a reason. If you subscribe to the Phenomenal Crew, but not following your boy on Twitter, like, what is you doing? But then that we all got social media. You can easily type a message. At the end of the day, with everything going on, even though I might not see eye to eye with the office, at the end of the day, on the face of the franchise, I'm a see y'all forever. And the fact that we haven't got that message yet is what disappoints me. Because at the end of the day, let it be known, Russ. Listen, this is not the first time trade rumors went off when it comes to Russell Wilson. Now, granted, the first time trade rumors went with Russell Wilson about 2 years ago, when Colin Cowherd was on that bullshit starting rumors, that shit wasn't believable. We saw Russell Wilson get his contract extension, become the highest paid quarterback in the league in the rest of his history. But this right here, airing out your team when trade rumors are going around, when teams are exploring wanting Russell Wilson, and the organization, Pete Carroll, Snyder not seeing eye to eye with Russ, the fact that you haven't confirmed yourself as a CEO is what disappoints me. Because at the end of the day, like I said, all it takes is 2 to 3 words. You don't got to come out and say you agree with everything, but just let me know if you want to be a Seahawk or not. That's what upsets me. So at the end of the day, like I said, man, this guy Russ has had multiple opportunities to say that at the end of the day, I want to be a Seahawk. I am a Seahawk. I'm a Seahawk for life. I mean, this guy just did a GQ interview with Sierra. He just did a GQ interview with his wife, with his fine at his wife. Listen, Russ, if you ever see this vet, if anybody from Russell Wilson camp see this vet, I got nothing but respect for Mr. Unlimited himself. Mr. Unlimited, my favorite player in the league. Dangerous. Listen, you're my QB, but we all know, especially Prime Sierra, man. Prime Sierra was a fucking 10. Those vids that she used to do about me, remarkable. But at the end of the day, Russ has had multiple opportunities to say that he wanted to be a Seahawk. And the fact that he hasn't mentioned that now is what upsets me. At the end of the day, like I said, man, all it takes is a few words. But at the end of the day, listen, Russ, we all got our issues with Pete Carroll. We all had our talks and our disagreements with Pete. But at the end of the day, we know the best for both situations is for Russ to stay in Seattle and for Pete Carroll to decide to keep Russell Wilson in Seattle. Simple as that, man. Listen, the grass is not always greener on the other side, man. People want Russell Wilson in these big markets, like playing in Dallas, playing in New York, playing in Pittsburgh. But at the end of the day, the grass is not always green on the other side, man. This guy, Russell Wilson, has been the face of the franchise for the past 9 years. You can't trade that down, man. At the end of the day, we're a winning organization. Say what you want to say about it. The Seahawks have ran shit in the NFC for the past decade. At the end of the day, say what you want to say about this offensive line. It got better. Listen, this is not the offensive line from 2017 and 2016. This is not the 2016 offensive line that we dealt with 4 years ago. That 2016 Seahawks offensive line, one of the worst offensive lines I've ever seen. In 2017, before we traded for Dwayne Brown, that was already the worst offensive line we've ever seen. Ever since we traded for Dwayne Brown, this offensive line has gradually got better and better and better. Now to the point where I thought the offensive line, I still won't say it's good. I won't say the offensive line is good. We still got holes. We still need a center. We still need a left guard. But at the end of the day, it's better than what it's been. Like, when it comes down to it, because I see so many people backing up Russ when it comes down to, oh my goodness, you know, the Seahawks organization hasn't treated him right. How come they haven't gave him an offensive line? He's been sacked 394 times. At the end of the day, when it really comes down to it, when it really boils down to the biggest point, Russell Wilson was one of the reasons why we didn't make it to the Super Bowl this year. Russell Wilson is one of the reasons why we got put out in the first round by the Rams at home. At the end of the day, Russ, not all those sacks that you took this year, 51 sacks that you took this year, were on the offensive line. At the end of the day, there was multiple situations, there was multiple plays where Russ held on to the ball, locking on to a primary receiver, and got sacked. Listen, Russ, some of your sacks were on you. So at the end of the day, how I'm looking at it is this. What we should all want from this is Russell Wilson to be a Seahawk and for us to make moves. Listen, what do people not get? We finished 12-4 this year. It's not like we went 6-10 or we're the Texans and we went 4-12 and our organization's a disaster. We're not the Houston Texans. We're not the Jacksonville Jaguars. We're not the New York Jets. No. We have a well-run organization. Say what you want to say about Pete Carroll. He's the first Bell Hall of Fame coach. John Snyder is going to be a Hall of Fame GM. At the end of the day, this organization is one of the top organizations in the league. So when it really boils down to it, Russell Wilson, you're not going to get a better shot to win a Super Bowl. Wherever you go. You think if you get traded to the fucking... to the fucking Cowboys, that will give you a better shot to win Super Bowl? I think not. If Russell Wilson gets traded to the freaking Jets, you think they're gonna have a better Super Bowl? You think they don't have a chance to make it to Super Bowl? I think not. So when it really boils down to it, I'm disappointed that Russell Wilson hasn't confirmed himself being a Seahawk. Just going on Twitter, man. Just give a tweet. I'm a Seahawk for life. I go Hawks. I 12s up. Like, at the end, they just do something, man. Because it's coming to a point. Do you want to be a Seahawk or not, Russ? Do you want to be a Seahawk or not? Listen, you got to choose one. You want to be a Seahawk or not? You want to play with the what's the team you're going for? The Bears. Let it be known. Are you a Seahawk or not? Because at the end of the day, how I feel is, we are another receiver. We are another receiver and a center away from winning the Super Bowl. That's how I look at it. We're a receiver and a center away from winning the Super Bowl. You plug in, we draft the best center available in this draft in the second round, and we add an Allen Robinson or Chris Godwin with DK and Tyler Lockett. We're the best team in the NFC. So at the end of the day, how I look at it, Russ, is all you need is another receiver in the center, and we back to the promised land. So many Seahawks fans are talking about how we need to go ahead and bring a Joe Tooney or do what we got to do to go sign that best center in the free agency pool, go bring in a Corey Linsley. How I look at it is, go ahead and draft the best center available in the second round in this upcoming draft. Go get you a Chris Godwin or Allen Robinson so you can get the ball out quick. Because a lot of the reasons why Russell Wilson was sacked this year is because a lot of our play calls, a lot of our deep shots, we had a lot of deep shots down the field. Our offense is based around explosive deep shots getting behind the defense, getting behind the secondary. That was our offense. That's what Shotty did. It was to get all the playmakers, get DK, get Ty Lockett down the field, and then make plays. So at the end of the day, getting the Chris Godwin, getting the Allen Robinson, somebody that can beat one-on-one coverage early in the short intermediate routes is what we need. That's gonna take Russ Sacks down by itself. The quicker you get the ball out, the less opportunities you get sacked. Simple as that. So at the end of the day, get you another star receiver, get you a center, and we Gucci. We good. So at the end of the day, Russ, make it known. Are we gonna get the next 10 years of Russ? Or is Russ going to be playing in Chicago or fucking Pittsburgh? Like, real talk. I need to know. But that's what you got to say, y'all. That's all. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'm the Phenomenal One. And I'm out. Deuces.
Shout out my Crips. They're still crippin', niggas. Shout out my Bloods. They're still bloodin', niggas. Straight from the dirt, shout out my muddy niggas. Came from the bottom, all my get money niggas.
When I die, you ain't got to cry, you just got to pray. Put some weed where I lay, I'ma see you another day. Full of energy, you my enemy, you got to pay. Was on the east side, fucking with them Crips the other day. Was on the west side.